Thursday, March 3rd, in the year of our Lord, 2016. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's March 3rd, and it's a very dear friend of ours celebrating a birthday. He's loving it. He's enjoying it. He's our unofficial sponsor for today's show. My good friend, Justin Dimmitt, Captain Big McLodge Huge, the owner, proprietor of a phenomenal page, Prosper. And if you're not following Prosper, shame on you. Facebook.com/LLAProsper. All one word. Love this page. You don't have to be a Star Trek fan to appreciate a page like this. Without this man, we would not have beer and song of the day, at least not the Facebook page. He's the one that created it for me a long time ago, and I'm forever indebted for that. But yeah, yours truly, Commander Love Dr. Baker. That's right. And go follow Prosper, our unofficial sponsor, as my good friend Justin Dimmitt. Happy birthday to you, my brother from another mother. And I know you're having a wicked awesome day. I know you're living it up, having a lot of fun. And I can't wait to see your next edition of Prosper. It's going to be epic. I already know it. All right, and folks, that's right. Cannot forget the official Prosper koozie. You got to have a Prosper koozie. Good stuff right there. Way cool. Thank you, my brother, for this wonderful gift. Yeah, I'll give it to you. I know it's your slogan, but I'll give it to you. Why? Because you deserve it, brother. Yes, you do. So there you go. Today, I'm pumped up. Great opening song. We've got the beat. Of course, we got the beat. The Go-Go's 1981. Hey, it opened a phenomenal movie. Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Hey, today's National Anthem Day, folks. America, damn right, National Anthem Day. I'll explain that later. Also, National I Want You to Be Happy Day. Folks, this is every day for me. I want everyone to be happy every day. Life works better that way. How about that, Justin Dimmitt? How's that for a birthday? National I Want You to Be Happy Day. Well, you better be happy after this show. Love my cold cuts, don't you? National Cold Cuts Day. National Mulled Wine Day. I'm not drinking mulled wine. No. But I'm drinking a beer that's as strong as a wine. In honor of my dear friend Justin Dimmitt, I want to teach him what a huge, beastly, badass beer is all about. Folks, I'm busting out the official Prosper beer consumption apparatus. I can't find any better way to drink a beer on my friend's birthday than with his very own Prosper beer consumption apparatus. And we're going to put a royal beer into this one, folks. Thank you to my good friends over at Philo Liquors for getting me this. Goose Island Bourbon County Brand Stout, folks. Oh my God. Yeah. And folks, I know the light's kind of killing things, but look at if you could see the percentage on that. 14.3% alcohol by volume. Folks, that's like almost three times as strong as a normal beer. That's wicked hardcore. I'm going wicked hardcore for my wicked awesome friend. Of course, it's out of Chicago, Illinois. They also got a brewery in Baldwinsville, New York, and as well as Fort Collins, Colorado. But this one doesn't say where any of them are at. Yeah. But I know Chicago, Illinois is where it all began. Prop beer winning apparatus, prop technique. Here we go. Wow. Oh, that's strong. 45 degree angle, right? The beer consumption apparatus, right off the keyboard consumption. Damn good. Haven't smelled a drop yet. Never have, never will. Oh, God. That's deep, dark, and delicious. And I was just telling another friend of mine earlier today about this here beer. My dear friend, Lorelei de la Lune, one of our lovely unofficial sponsors of our show. In fact, the very first one I ever had. Lorelei de la Lune. We know her. We love her. She's been featured as a real babe of the day multiple times on Beer and Song of the Day. She's a former guest co-host this on Beer and Song of the Day. Awesome stuff. Lorelei, my dear, this beer is for you. And it's for you, Justin Dimmitt, over at Prosper. And for all you fans, cheers and beers to all of you. Prost say in Germany, Kampai as they say in Japan. I am scared to drink this one. Oh, my God! Oh, my goodness. Whoa, that's strong. Oh, but that is so full of flavor. This is incredible, folks. This is an A-plus all the way. Oh my God. It reminds me of Thomas Hardy's vintage ale when I was living in jolly old England. Wow, what a beer that is. Oh my dear God. All right, so birthday shout-outs. Here we go. I already said it. My man Justin Dimmitt, living in Okinawa, Japan. A great man, a hard-working man, a great family man, an awesome friend. Brother, dude, I'm doing a show in tribute for you for your birthday. You know why? Because you're like Smith Barney. You made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Happy birthday to you, my brother from another mother. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Hey, party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969. Minus the acid. Cheers and beers to you. And brother, you better bring a big ass beer like this on your next edition of Prosper, okay? Celebrate your birthday in style the way I am for you, my man. All right, next on the list. My man Lyle Egan. An absolute badass hard-working mama jammer I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, which ironically, he's living up in Northern Texas, better known as Oklahoma. And Lyle, happy birthday to you, my man. What's going on with you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Am I right? Oklahoma or Nebraska? I can't remember. But I know you moved up north. And brother, I definitely miss working with you on the job site. Great times, no doubt about that. And hey, even though you're a New York Yankees fan, you're still a damn good man. Hell yeah. Much respect. Lyle, happy birthday, my man. Hope you're having an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list. An absolute badass engine repair man I worked with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. My man, Demontre Green. Demontre, what's up, my man? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope to hear from you. A quiet man, hard-working man, just an awesome guy. Incredible professional attitude, incredible work ethic. Demontre, definitely miss working with you, my man. And happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And brother, cheers and beers. Whew. Whoa. Next on the list, my man Brandon Turner. Oh, yeah. Always great hearing from you, Brandon. A professional man, a hard-working man, an awesome guy. No doubt about that. A legend I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Pretty much same damn country. And Brandon, happy birthday to you, my man. And I know Kelly's spoiling you rotten because she's an absolute sweetheart. You two are such a beautiful couple. Awesome stuff. Big fans of the two of you. It's no doubt about that. Well, Brandon, happy birthday, my man. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. And brother, cheers and beers to you. Uh-oh. Text messages. The boss. Ah. Ha-ha. Yeah, I just told her I start my new job on March 21st. I am excited. And she said, woohoo! You know what that means? More money for mama. That's right. And hey, I could still survive on my beer budget. And you know it's an expensive beer budget. It is. Hey, our next birthday. Another badass, hard-working mama jamma I know down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Eastern New Mexico. My man, Eddie Jimenez. Eddie, what up, cuz? How you doing, my man? Hope you're doing well. Another one I miss working with on the job site. No doubt about that. An absolute badass. And Eddie, happy birthday, my man. And brother, I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. A big hearty cheers and beers to you. Gotta go easy with this one. All right, next on the list, my very own cousin, Dakota Whitmore. Oh, yeah. Dakota, what's going on with you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. The pride of Orange, Massachusetts. Of course, greatest state in the nation without Massachusetts. There wouldn't be an America. Perry dying the freaking story. That's right. And Dakota, I hope you're having a phenomenal day. Live it up. Celebrate well and enjoy. And hey, a big cheers and beers to you, cuz. And the final birthday of the day is a man that I have known for over 30 years. A fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1992 with my brother. Not as good as 91, but not bad either. My man, Mark Matta. Mark Matta. And for all my good friends on Martha's Vineyard Island, hey, I haven't heard from Mark Matta in over 2 decades. I know he's not on the Facebook. At least I can't find him. I don't even know if he was on MySpace. I don't think he was. I don't think he does social media. Well, I hope he's doing well. And I've never forgotten his birthday. Because see, folks, I don't need Facebook or anything to tell me whose birthday it is. I've got everybody's birthdays memorized. I've been very fortunate. Gift of numbers, baby. Well, Mark Matta, miss you big time. Happy birthday, my man. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And a big cheers and beers to you. And yes, his last name does not end in an R. It's actually M-A-T-T-A. It really is pronounced Matta. Okay? All right, with that said, there's our birthdays for today on Baron's Song of the Day. And what I want to do is I want to bring up our trivia question. It was a doozy. I wanted to do this in honor for my good friend Justin Dimmitt. So I said this. What fashion feature do Justin Dimmitt of Prosper and Bill Nye the Science Guy have in common recently? Well, our good friend George Seckman of Exotic Japan, the ever-observant man he is, he said that would be the ever-dapper bow tie. George, you absolutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job. And a big love got to salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. Dude, George, I'm really impressed. I didn't think somebody was going to get it, but you crushed it. Episode the cowbell. The John Dixon super special wicked awesome cowbell. Hell yeah. There you go, George. Well done, my friend. Well done. Ah, way to go. Kanpai, as they say in Japan. I'll drink to that. All right. I got some additional shout-outs I got to mention. My man Glenn Cunningham. Oh, Glenn, we had a good talk last night. We were talking about Metallica. Phenomenal album, Master of Puppets. Now, I thought they came out 30 years ago today, March 3rd in the year of our Lord, 1986. You said they came out February 21st, 1986. And I was spending about an hour and a half last night looking for different sites that said, you know, the dates. And I've come to the conclusion. RollingStone.com says March 3rd. Wikipedia says March 3rd. The Metallica official website says March 3rd. But you were there. You said February 21st. You got that album. And there were many other sites that also said February 21st. 1986. So I don't know what the answer is, man. But all I know, Glenn, is I am honored and privileged to have a friend like you because, hey, you know, we're fellow Northeasters. And you know the Northeast is the best area of the country. But you know something there, Glenn? And thank you for the ad last night. Great chatting with you. I want to give you a shout out on Baron's Song of the Day. But there's only one person that knows the answer to that question. Brian Williams. He was there. He was there. Brian Williams did it all. We all know that. So there you go. Glenn, there you go. I want to give you a shout out, brother, and a big cheers of beers to you. This is my after work stress relief, my YouTube show I do every single day pretty much. I usually take Saturdays off. You know, you got to spend time with family. It's kind of important. All righty. With that said, I got a few more. I got some additional shout outs. I do. Becky Holmquist, you know I'm not going to do a Justin Dimmitt birthday special with without giving a shout-out to a wonderful sweetheart of a lady that I would not know if it wasn't for my friend Justin. That's right. And Becky, you're drop-dead gorgeous. You're a total sweetheart living in Utah. That's right, Utah. And Becky, my dear, I want to say cheers and beers to you, and I hope you enjoy the show. Hell yeah, girl. Cat Sky, one of my unofficial sponsors of the show, and a former real baby today on Baron's Song of the Day. Cat Sky, she is a big-time Star Trek fan, as is Becky Holmquist, as is Justin Dimmitt. And hey, it's about Star Trek today. Hell yeah. And Cat, my dear, I'd like to feature you again as a real baby today down the road. So let me know if you're interested. Always a pleasure chatting with you. Love the pictures. You've been putting a lot of pictures up there lately. And I know you've been doing the cosplay stuff. It is epic. It is phenomenal. And Kat, you're phenomenal, my friend. And hey, cheers and beers to you, my dear. Lori Bechet. Oh, yeah. I've known Lori for over 2 decades. An absolute sweetheart of a lady. And hey, although we have political differences, we both love life. And we're good friends. And Lori, living in Oklahoma? Hell yeah! Originally from Maryland, a great state indeed, I might add. And also, I know her from good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. Well, Lori, I'm giving you a shout out because you had a request for a hunk of the day a while back. And today, I'm going to deliver to you, I'm going to deliver to our birthday boy, Justin, and I'm going to deliver to all you other folks out there that love the guy. So hang tight, and you're going to love it. It will be phenomenal. Lori, my friend, I missed the hell out of you, and I hope to see you again soon. So hey, cheers and beers to you, my friend. And I still hate the Baltimore Ravens. I know they're your team. But I know you love my Patriots like you love getting kicked in the face with a steel-toed boot. So, hey, the feelings are mutual. It's good to have differences, isn't it? Yeah, it is. And, folks, that's what it's all about. Your lesson from the Love Doctor today. Thank God we have the ability to be able to think differently. Would you want everybody else to... would you want everybody to think the same way? No! No, that's not healthy. It's good to have differences of opinions. Because if we all thought the same way, life would be boring. Yep, it would. So, there you go. And finally, I want to give a shout out to a plethora of people that I found out got job promotions recently. Yes, they did. Awesome stuff. They're going to get more money, more money, more money. And that's right, I'm talking about you, Nate Best. Hell yeah, brother. Weapons in the house. Oh, yeah. Terry Brindle, an absolute badass member, Gemma. Weapons in the house. Greg Butler. Oh, yeah. Dude, a legend from exotic Japan. And I hadn't heard from you in forever. Thanks for the ad, man. Greg, I've missed the hell out of you. Great hearing from you. Congratulations, my man. I'm very proud of you. Mike Carter. I know this guy from good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Western Nevada. He's originally from Massachusetts. Yeah, buddy. Congrats, Mike. You earned it, bro. Jasmine Chavez, a wonderful engine repair girl and an incredible leader of men, women, and it. Jasmine, always a positive attitude. Congratulations, my friend. Donnie Greenwood. Hell yeah, bro. Jolly old England. Dude, of course. Shepherd's Grove, baby. Stanton. Jolly old England. Mighty proud of you. A cop. An original mass hole like me. Awesome stuff. An incredible family man. And brother, go Red Sox. Damn right. Sharma Haynes. Another cop. And an absolute sweetheart. Always a smile on her face. Always a positive attitude. Very proud of you, Sharma. Hell yeah. Way to go, girl. You earned it. Marlon Jackson, a legend from jolly old England that I know well. He's a big-time wicked hardcore Detroit Lions fan. My second favorite team, I might add. Marlon, way to go, my friend. I'm very proud of you. Scott Link, oh, you crazy fruitcake. Dude, Scott, I'm so proud of you, bro. In fact, I'll never forget. Remember 2008? We went to the Canary Islands. Your wicked awesome family. My wicked awesome family. We had a lot of fun. We saw lots of topless babes. We saw people that shouldn't have been in thongs, too. But hey, that's besides the point. Scott, I miss the hell out of you, man. I miss you big time. And hey, get on Facebook more often. Talk to me. Or give me a call sometime. I miss working with a legend like you. I really do, man. Scott, I'm very proud of you. I really am. Ray Lepard, speaking of legends, an incredible badass mamma jamma I know from exotic Japan. Ray, what up, cuz? Congratulations, brother. Very proud of you. Juan Lopez, oh yeah. Jolly old England's finest and an incredible badass. Juan, a great man, a great family man, just a very professional man indeed. I'm very proud of you. Juan, working with a legend like you is truly a blessing. John McNeely. Dude, wow, man. Another badass I know from jolly old England. I know him from good old Yeehaw, Texas. Texas, it's like a whole other country. And legally, they can become their own damn country if they so choose. Hell yeah, John, mighty proud of you, my man. I really am. Yes, abso-smurf-a-lutely. Chris Nelner. Dude, I ain't heard from you in a while. But hey, love to hear from you. Congratulations. Like Smith Barney, you earned it. Yeah. Trapper Auto. Oh, yeah. Dude, another legend from jolly old England. Trap up, my man. Congratulations, my man. Hell yeah. Mikey Pugh, an absolute sweetheart. Totally wicked awesome. No doubt about that. Weapons in the house. I know Glenn's going to spoil you rotten tonight. Hell yeah. Take it from the love doctor. It's always good to be spoiled. Yes, it is. Todd Schuler, my man. One of the most wicked hardcore Ohio State fans I've ever known in my entire life. And I know him from good old California, land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Northern Mexico. Todd, mighty proud of you, my man. Brandon Suba. Oh, yeah. An engine repairman. An absolute badass. An incredible leader of men, women, and it's. That I know from jolly old England. Brandon, dude, you have no idea how proud I am of you. That's right. And don't worry. Because, see, in another 2 months, and, yeah, 2 months and 8 days on May 10th, I'm going to give you a birthday shout-out for your birthday. I haven't forgotten. See? I don't forget things. I don't. And I'll never forget the time I got mad and you calmed me down. Thank you so much for that, Brandon. It meant a lot, man. That's what friends are for. And finally, my man Dustin Wilder. Dude, about damn time you added me on the old Facebook. I know I post like a fiend. I get that. But hey, we're wicked, hardcore, legit, no bull Boston Red Sox fans. Hell to the effing yeah. And Dustin, dude, you are one of the most incredible badass Mamma Jamma workers I've ever known in my entire life. One of the guys that I led along with Scott. And you guys are amazing. Yeah, jolly old England. And of course, Dustin, you and your wicked, awesome, gorgeous, better half, Alicia. Jeez, I can't even talk now. I'm so proud of you. I just saw your pages, and God, the kids have grown up so fast. I feel old, bro. I do. But Dustin, Alicia, you gotta be proud, and your three kids gotta be proud. That's right. Bailey, Carter, and Emma, awesome stuff. The Wilder family, hey, a huge cheers and beers to you. A huge cheers and beers to all of you that got job promotions. Yours truly, the love doctor, Reverend Dr. B, is mighty proud of all of you. So let's all drink together, shall we? On the count of three. Un, deux, trois. Yeah. Hey, je ne parle pas français très bien. I don't speak French very well. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada indeed. You got to get some love to your neighbors up north. And I do that on Baron Song of the Day every single day of the week. Figging, eh? With that said, folks, there's our shout-outs for today on Baron Song of the Day. Hell yeah! With that said, it's time to bring out today's vehicle of the day, instrument of the day, and pet of the day. And then I got a lot of extra eye candy for you. Yes, I do. You're going to love it. And folks, just to give you a fair warning, parental advisory, explicit content on a few cases. Now, Scott Link, you and I know that moobs and boobs are the same, except boobs are a lot more attractive. We're going to see boobs, bare boobs, as well as moobs. But hey, you got to take the good with the bad, right? You know, that's what keeps the world going around. All right, with that said, as I get to our vehicle of the day, check this out, folks. In the honor of Star Trek, it's the right thing to do, because anything less would be uncivilized. This is the Star Trek, this is the USS Enterprise NCC-1701B, as in ball sniffer, Excelsior class refit. That is your vehicle of the day on Baron's Song of the Day. Hell yeah, love it, awesome stuff. Our instrument of the day, way cool. You know, normally it's Thrash Metal Thursday, so I thought it's a good idea. I know my good friend Justin Nimmer's not a heavy metal fan, but he loves hard rock. He loves rock music. And I think it's the right thing to do to feature from Styx, Todd Sukerman. That's S-U-C-H-E-R-M-E-N. Todd Sukerman, his Styx Pearl drum set. How cool of a drum set is that? You're damn right. It's wicked cool. Uh-oh. Little Princess Delilah's home. Home from school. And I'm sure she's going to come in and let us know that life is good. So, yeah. Todd Sukerman's Styx Pearl drum set. An incredible drum set. Your instrument of the day on Baron's Song of the Day. Hell yeah. Now, our pet of the day. This is big. Becky Holmquist. I heard you had an idea on this one. And Justin Dimmitt over at Prosper, you're going to love this. You're a dog lover. I'm a dog lover. Becky's a dog lover. And although he's officially known as Tuna, he's better known as Steven. That's right. Steven. Come on, we're not over, buddy. P-H-T-E-V-E-N. Steven. And look at that bow tie in honor of my good friend Justin Dimmitt, who is a proud wearer of the bow tie, as is Bill Nye, the science guy. I think it's only fair that we have a pet of the day wearing a bow tie. If that ain't wicked awesome, folks, I don't know what is. Steven, officially Tuna the dog. That is an awesome doggy. Hell yeah. And it is Princess Delilah.
Hi.
Hey, you want to tell Mr. Justin happy birthday?
Happy birthday, Scruffy.
Welcome back from school. How cool is that?
Not cool.
Not cool. Well, hey, who's your favorite baseball team?
Red Sox.
Duh. Anything less would be uncivilized, right?
Uh-huh.
You got that right. Let's drink! So Princess Delilah's back from school. And without further ado, folks, it's time to bring to you our first hunk of the day on Baron's Song of the Day. And I think it's the right thing to do. We're talking bow ties. We're talking awesomeness. But you know what? Justin Dimmitt, my friend, I know how big of a fan of this guy you are. In fact, he shares a birthday with you. We loved him on Star Trek, the original series. We loved him in the Star Trek movies. Come on now. James Doohan. Of course, James Doohan. Born March 3rd, 1920. Sadly passed away in 2005, but he did live to be 85 years old. So, I mean, a good long life indeed. And such an incredible sense of humor he had. A very professional man, Scottish. And it's only fitting that we bring out, we love the hard rock, and I love AC/DC, I love the song Thunderstruck, but in honor of James Doohan, we're going to bring out Thunderstruck with bagpipes. The Simon Fraser University Pipe Band. Folks, you ain't ever heard something like this. Oh, bagpipes, did you say? And it's Mustache Man this month. How fitting. There you go. Great Scotty. James Doohan. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, James Doohan. Happy birthday, Justin Dimmitt. Happy birthday to all you born on March 3rd in the year of our Lord whenever. Oh, cheers and beers? Eh, shoot, I'll drink to that. There it is. Represent Mustache Madness Month in style. And I'm going to Mustache. I am. Working on it. Of course, I'm not a hairy Sasquatch, so I don't do a good job of it. James Doohan sure did, though. Yeah, he did. We do have some celebrity birthdays for today. One that's always mentioned on March 3rd is the lovely, gorgeous, amazing, drop-dead, wicked, awesome Jessica Biel. Jessica Biel, former multiple baby of the day on Baron's Song of the Day, 34 years old today. Julie Bowen. Now, when I think of Julie Bowen, I know her from one thing. Happy Gilmore. Yeah, Adam Sandler's girlfriend. With a beer. Yeah, Julie Bowen. Hot. Real hot. Damn hot. Wicked hot. And smoking hot. And 46 years old today. Hey, without this man, we wouldn't have the telephone. Alexander Graham Bell, inventor of the telephone. Born this day in 1847. Passed away at the age of 75 in 1922. Ronan Keating, singer. 39 years old today. Awesome stuff. Justin Gabriel. Where's my wrestling fans at? George Seckman of Exotic Japan. I know you're a wrestling fan like me. Hell yeah. Justin Gabriel, 35 years old today. George Miller. Now, George Miller, I don't even know what I wrote. Maddie Margo Dreamer? What the hell did I write? Well, whatever. George Miller, 71 years old today. Ah, director. That's right, movie director. That's what it is. Hi, Princess Delilah.
Hi.
You sure got changed quick. What's up with that? What is that?
Pink Amina.
Pink Amina, huh?
Yeah, I can't every painting her. She
actually
looks insane.
Wow. You're such an artist. So yeah, I had to start the show early. I hope you don't mind. Is that okay?
Yeah, well, how come?
Because this is going to be a long show.
Oh, boy.
Oh, from Twilight Zone. James Doohan. Way cool. Hey, you got to do your chores. Okay. He served our country in World War II. Awesome stuff. I give him the Love Doctor salute for that. James Doohan. Preserve freedom, baby. Oh, yeah. Catherine Waterston. Gorgeous British actress, 36 years old today. Canada Lee. Canada Lee. Now, he is an early African-American actor, and we know how racist Hollywood was back in the 40s and 50s. Well, Canada Lee, much like Sidney Poitier, he defied that shit, and he really crushed those racial barriers. And Canada Lee, born on this day in 1907, sadly passed away much too young at the age of 45 in 1952. But I'll tell you, he got some starring roles as a black man, and that is amazing in a very racist Hollywood. Herschel Walker, phenomenal football player, and that man is in incredible shape. Herschel Walker, running back, Dallas Cowboys and Minnesota Vikings. I don't think he's in the Hall of Fame. Although, you wouldn't hurt if he was. Herschel Walker, 54 years old today. Jean Harlow, the blonde bombshell of Hollywood, an absolute goddess, born on this day in 1911 and passed away in 1937. And finally, Jackie Joyner Kersee. If you don't know who she is, you've never watched the Olympics, folks. Incredible, incredible female athlete, Jackie Joyner Kersee. 54 years old today. Awesome stuff. And look at that. Hey, there you go, Justin Dimmitt. How about that? The bow tie. The right thing to do. Your favorite actor ever, James Doohan, and his bow tie. If that ain't wicked awesome, I don't know what is. Folks, let's drink to that. All right. Time for our first babe of the day on Baird Song of the Day. Oh, I mentioned her. Well, just see, James Doohan is a birthday boy. Well, this girl's a birthday girl. And like James Doohan, she's also from the United Kingdom. She's from jolly old England. Catherine Waterston. And I'm going to bring out a badass song for her. If you don't know this song, you don't know music. Come Sail Away, Styx, 1977. Folks, this is the full version, too. Hey, you gotta get the full pleasure, okay? It's the right thing to do. Catherine Waterston, 36 years old today. Oh, cleavage, French for cleavage. Good God, I can't believe she actually wore that in public. Wow! I'm not complaining. I'm the love doctor. I love me some beebs. Good God. You're a badass member, Gemma, when you can wear a coat completely open without a bra. She's like, hey, what are you gonna do, complain? Nope. This love doctor ain't complaining. I got 20/15 eyesight. Believe me, I love what I'm seeing. And Scott Link, I know you love what you're seeing too. You and I are loyal men, but we also have good eyesight. And we love to look at the goods. Yes, we do. What a great picture. Look at them legs. She got legs and she knows how to use them. Well, at least I'm assuming she does. Ask Rod Stewart. He sang the song. Great song. Great babe of the day right there. Oh, look at that. She's got an ass chin, too. Although my camera doesn't really do it a whole lot of justice. She's got butt chin. A little bit. A professional look. Cool. Look it up, folks! For those that are a little politically correct, or those that don't like to see bare female boobies, turn your heads now. Bare lady boobies. There you go, Justin Dimmitt. A gift to you, my friend. Hell, looks like she got nipples you can dial a phone with. Yeah. It looked like she might have been suffering from erectus nipplus. Just saying. Lovely. Lovely indeed. A little bit of belly button there. Did you know that back in the 1960s on television, they had to change Barbara Eden's outfit for I Dream of Jeannie so that she wouldn't show her belly button? Wow! It's amazing how staunch Hollywood was back then. They couldn't show belly buttons on women. Yet at the same time, they couldn't offer minorities any roles. Shows how messed up Hollywood is, huh? Jeez. Thank God things have changed. Look out, bad boobies! Catherine Waterston! Hot diggity dog damn! See through in the t-shirt.
Yeah, baby.
Oh, look out. Full-fledged nudity right here, folks. We got the landing strip, if you catch my drift. Yeah! Great song, great baby of the day right there. Yeah, baby. And a lovely smile indeed. Yes, very much so. Oh, two-way Rachel Lee, you are very pretty, Catherine Waterston. Shit, I'll drink to that. You should, too. All right. Before we go through the rest of this full-fledged song, let's talk about some cool things that happened on this day, March 3rd, year by law and whenever. On this day in 2005, Steve Fawcett flies the Virgin Atlantic Global Flyer to a world record by completing the first non-stop, non-refueled, solo flight around the world. Wow! I watched this in horror, folks, and a lot of you did as well. 25 years ago today now. I cannot believe it's been that long. Four Los Angeles police officers severely beat Rodney King. It was captured on amateur video. We all know how that went down. We all know how horrible that was. Sadly, Rodney King is no longer with us physically. But Rodney King said something that I cannot agree with more. Why can't we all just get along? That message echoes incredibly. Rodney King, that should have never happened. And Rodney King, rest in peace. And it's a shame that those four Los Angeles police officers didn't get the justice that they should have gotten. Now granted, the riots that occurred in Los Angeles shouldn't have happened either. Negativity doesn't win by doing negativity, okay? That's just the way I see it. It ain't gonna do you no good, no how. But yes, it was an injustice. Those cops went way over the line. And it's sad because there's so many great cops in the world to do so many great things. Those four cops that beat Rodney King for such minor stuff, they got lucky. They really did. I think they had a four-leaf clover jammed up their ass, personally. All right, folks. Time for our next hunk of the day. Lori Bechet, my dear. You requested him a long time ago. Justin Dimmitt, this man is like you. He represents the bow tie well. Bill Nye, the science guy. Bill Nye, baby. That's right. your next hunk of the day on Band Song of the Day. Let's bring out Tomohiro Taco, Mr. Roboto. Mr. Roboto by Styx as well. Styx, a great band. Even with a pink bow tie. Look at that. Breast Cancer Awareness Month bow tie? Maybe. I don't know. This guy is so thin, he makes me look like a fat ass. And I'm a skinny guy. With a beer gut. I've had to work on that for a while. Bill Nye, the science guy. This guy's way cool. He really is. He's a dapper man. And he represents the bow tie well. He does. Yes, he does. And Justin Dimmitt, I encourage you to please continue wearing that bow tie. Because you look sharp. There's two things that need to be brought back to the world. The bow tie and the fedora. Back in the old school days, a lot of men wore bow ties. And back in the day, a lot of men, almost all men, wore a fedora with their suit. And the fedora needs to come back. As does the bow tie. And Justin, I know your wonderful, gorgeous, better half Robin, the artistic genius that she is. She makes bow ties. Yes, she does. And you know what? I would be honored to wear a Boston Red Sox created bow tie on Baron's Song of the Day if she's ever inclined to do so. I'll throw that out there. I'm not expecting it, but hey. Maybe June 27th when it's my birthday. Maybe a gift will arrive like that. I don't ask for much, you know that. But I would love to wear a Boston Red Sox bow tie on beer and song of the day. That would be epic. Out of respect to you, I would never wear New England Patriots bow tie on my show. Because I know you love the Patriots like you love an infected scrotum. To quote the late great George Carlin. That's right. You're a Colts fan. It's totally understandable. It's totally logical. I've come to help you with your problems. Because folks, you cannot be an Indianapolis Colts fan and like the New England Patriots. That would be highly illogical. Look at that, Bill Nye, the science guy! Double shooters, baby! Yeah! Pew pew! Bill Nye, what a badass he is. Love this guy. He's a walking brain of a man. He sure is. I'm not a modern man. I'm an old school man. I should have been born in 1938 and graduated in 1956. I should have grown up in the 50s. That'd be perfect for me. Oh, he's flipping out the bricks. Did you know that if you turn your fingers like that, that is the GFY in jolly old England? Yeah, I learned that a long time ago. See, in the United States of America, it's only one finger. But in jolly old England, it's this. Turned around this way. That's the peace symbol. And that is GFY. Right? Now you know. See, you learn something new on Beer and Song of the Day every single day of the week. Otherwise, it's a waste of day. Bill Nye, the science guy, he's a knockout. Yeah, he is. Oh, look at that, eh? The professional mustache. It is mustache and this month. So, folks, grow the dick broom out. Grow that mustache out. Men, women, ants, grow the mustache. Make it happen. I'll drink to that. Honest Day, 1972. I wonder if they still exist. Sculpted figures of Jefferson Davis, Robert E. Lee, and Stonewall Jackson are completed at Stonewall, Georgia. Stone Mountain, Georgia, rather. Excuse me. Yeah, no kidding. Confederate, quote-unquote, heroes. Interesting. Honestly, 1985. Remember this TV show? I remember it. I didn't watch it, though. Moonlighting with Sybil Shepherd. And Bruce Willis. Yeah, I know you. A lot of you folks love Bruce Willis. Phenomenal actor. Remember Moonlighting? I do. That show premiered on this day, my third year of our Lord, 1985. 50 years ago today, an incredible rock group premiere on the forum. You ever heard of Buffalo Springfield? The great song, There's Something Happened in Here. Love that song. Buffalo Springfield, Neil Young, Stephen Stills, a great, great rock group. 50 years ago today, they formed. On this day in 1965, one of the greatest music ballads of all time, The Temptations' legendary classic, My Girl, reaches number one on the charts. Awesome stuff. All right, folks, time to feature. She's the number one to many of you. And she's a killer. She's a queen. It's only fitting to feature Killer Queen by Queen for this queen, the queen of internet searching, Scarlett Johansson. Scarlett Johansson has been Babe of the Day many times on Baron's Song of the Day. Her and her Thunder Jugs, her and her beauty, her and the fact she knows how to rock a horse. I wish I was that wooden rocking horse. I do. I'd have wood too. Oh, she's a killer, all right. On this day in 1956. Wow. She'll blow your mind. Morocco gains independence from France. Happy 60th birthday, Morocco. An incredible country indeed. On a day in 1955, Elvis Presley's first television appearance. No, it was not Ed Sullivan. It was the Louisiana Hayride Show. How about that? Yeah! Folks, get ready for yourselves. Have you ever seen Scarlett Johansson naked? You're about to right here, right now on Baron's Song of the Day. I don't believe in censorship. I have a very liberal mindset when it comes to nudity. Look at this. Full frontal nudity. Here you go. And it's a real picture. She finally exposed all the goods on the motion pictures, on the movies. Scarlett Johansson. She wore a wig for it. My good God, she's hot. Real hot. Damn hot. Wicked hot. On this day in 1940, one of the greatest swing songs of all time, Artie Shaw, an incredible legend, recorded Frenzy on the RCA Victor label. On this day in 1933, New York City premieres an incredible movie. Well, that's according to BrainyHistory.com. I did some reading later and found out it was April 7th, 1933. But supposedly, King Kong premiered. I don't know about that. But on this day in 1931, this is official. The Star Spangled Banner officially becomes the anthem of the United States of America. 75 years ago today, three quarters of a century ago. Wow! And it's still going strong. Also on this day in 1931, I love this guy, Cab Calloway, incredible jazz musician. He recorded his legendary song, Minnie the Moocher. Yep, and that was actually jazz music's first ever million record seller. Did you know that? Now you do. Because see, on Baron's Song of the Day, you learn something every day of the week. How cool is that? Yeah, that's awesome. So is that Scarlett Johansson. Good God. Born November 22nd, 1980. Foul. And she ain't no how. Mm-mm. Nope. She just gorgeous. Yeah. Regardless of what hair color she has, it doesn't matter. She's beautiful. She's talented. She's got skills, my friend. And she got cleavage. Yeah, she does. And she likes to blow bubbles, which is cool. Oh, yeah. And she drinks beer. I'll drink to that. Oh, look out. Bear buns, folks. She's got buns, hon. And boobies. Beautiful, bodacious boobies. So, yeah, there you go. Scarlett Johansson. Your baby today. Oh, Bear and Song of the Day. Folks, I have saved the best for last. We're going to feature a very dear friend of mine as Hunk of the Day. And we're going to feature a very dear friend of mine as Babe of the Day. It's the right thing to do. Anything less will be uncivilized. Okay? We've saved the best for last. We're bringing out today's real Hunk of the Day on Baird Song of the Day, Fig and A. This man is epic. This man's a legend. He's celebrating a birthday today. Happy anniversary of coming out of the womb to my good friend and beer connoisseur, Justin Dimmitt. Look at that, will you? Sporting a bow tie. How awesome is that? It's wicked awesome. And his favorite song. Now, I love me some Chuck Berry, Johnny B. Goode, recorded December 29th, December 30th, 1957, released February 1958. But this is the Marty McFly badass version from Justin and my, one of our all-time favorite movies ever, Back to the Future. Here you go. Marty McFly's version of Johnny B. Goode. You know it. You love it.
This is an oldie.
It's awesome. And look at that. Representing his Indianapolis Colts with a bow tie that his wonderful, gorgeous, better have Robin created for him. Robin, you're awesome, girl. You really are. I cannot wait to meet you in person. Hey, remember this, Justin? Yep. Me and your wicked awesome dad, Jeff. Hanging out. Right before we recorded Beer and Song of the Day together. Wicked hardcore Indianapolis Colts fan, and rightfully so, you're from Indiana. You better be a Colts fan. Representing the bow tie, looking mighty dapper, Justin. Yes, sir, you are. You shape metal for a living. You're an awesome guy. And your wonderful gorgeous better half, Robin, is wicked awesome. All right, you're wicked awesome, too. Oh, look at this. Bow tie and fedora together. Folks, that's the look you all need to go for. All you men, anyway. October 21st, 1985. I'll never forget that. And neither should you. Justin Dimmitt, hanging out in the Back to the Future con. Lucky, make your dog a lucky dog today. Look at that. He's a captain. Captain Big McLeod's huge. There is no one in the world that knows more about Star Trek than that man. I promise you. If you know more about Star Trek than Justin Dimmitt, I want to know. I do. This guy is incredible. He hung out with a legend. Look at that t-shirt. Chuck Stays. Chuck Pagano, head coach of the Indianapolis Colts. Who, by the way, signed that shirt for Justin. That's awesome. I love me some Chuck Pagano. Hey, I may be a Patriots fan, but I am a football fan, big time. And I love Chuck Pagano. He's a class act. He's wicked awesome. And look at that, the entire Indianapolis Colts signed that football for you, Justin Dimmitt. And you got to meet Chuck Pagano. I'm jealous of you, you jackass. Wow. Hell, you met a whole bunch of players from the Indianapolis Colts. You and Robin, hanging out with Chuck and the Wicked Awesome crew over there. Amazing. Hanging out at some Star Trek events. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And look at that. Represent Mustache Man this month with a bow tie. I love it. That's legendary. That's a badass right there. A birthday boy who's happily married to a goddess.
I guess you guys aren't ready for that yet.
Oh, we are, huh, Justin? But yeah, we are, bro. Damn right. America! Comic-Con. God, I love Comic-Cons. I do. They're fun. Hanging out at Lucas Oil Stadium. You too.
make me jealous. Yeah, you do. Look at this. I mean, how awesome is that? It's incredible. And look at that. Robin wearing an Andrew Luck jersey. Yeah. Andrew Luck, class act all the way. And Justin, I have that same gift. My man Vinny Blancato gave that to me over a year ago. That's a good beer kit. We got to make some beer. Yes, we do. So, yeah. Justin Dimmitt, to you, happy anniversary of coming out of the womb. Thank you, Gail Riggs, for bringing an awesome man into the world. All right, folks. Time for our final babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Now, I talked about her earlier. She's a very dear friend of mine. She's a very dear friend of my man Justin Dimmitt over at Prosper. And she's an absolute sweetheart. She's drop-dead gorgeous. I know her from jolly old England. She's from Wyoming. That's right. Otherwise known as Northern Colorado. Ironically, she's living in Colorado now. Love you, girl. Great talking to you earlier today. Lorelei De La Lune, the first ever unofficial sponsor of Beer and Song of the Day, the modern day Maryland. And for you, my friend, this ain't classic rock. This ain't rock and roll. But without this song, we wouldn't have rock and roll. Jimmy Forrest, 1951, you gotta have something smooth, slow, and sexy to represent a smooth and sexy, beautiful goddess like Lorelei De La Lune. Here you go, the original version of Night Train, folks. Listen to this. A gorgeous song for a gorgeous babe of the day. See, back in the 50s, a lot of radio stations, when they did the Night Train shows, they would open with this song. Jimmy Forrest's original Night Train. A sexy song for a sexy goddess. Lorelei, I love you, girl. I love you like a sister. And not in a West Virginia way, either. I say 1926, the International Greyhound Racing Association formed in Miami, Florida. Oh! She does burlesque, folks. And those are natural bibs. And those are nipple tassels. Damn, Lorelei! Incredible! Honest day in 1922. WWJAM Radio, Detroit, Michigan, begins radio transmissions. Hot. Honestly, in 1919, the first international airmail service from the United States, Seattle, Washington, to Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. That happened 97 years ago today. She keeps herself in shape, and it's a beautiful shape. Marilyn Monroe ain't got shit on you there, Lorelei. Honestly, in 1915, National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics was created. Folks, it became NASA years later.
Wow.
Honestly, in 1885, the American Telephone and Telegraph Company incorporates. We know it as AT&T. Happy 131st birthday, AT&T. Whoa. Honest day in 1875, the first recorded hockey game. And that was in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Eh? Honest day in 1849, the Home Department forms. We know it today as the Department of the Interior.
Whoa.
Also on this day in... Oh, no. That was the U.S. Department of Interior established by Congress. Damn, I saved the best for last, didn't I? You're damn right I did. Honestly, in 1845, the first time ever, the U.S. Senate overrides a presidential veto. And that was President John Tyler. Don't worry, John Tyler still had 15 kids by two wives. He liked to have sex a lot. Yeah, kind of like Wilt Chamberlain. Also on this day in 1845, Florida, the land of the old people, becomes the 27th state in the United States of America. Austin, 1837. Ain't Lorelei a gift sent from heaven? Congress increases Supreme Court membership from 7 people to 9 people, which is what it stands as today. Oh my God, Lorelei! Yeah. Austin, 1813, the office of the Surgeon General of the U.S. Army forms. Austin, 1812, the U.S. passes the first foreign aid bill as they aided Venezuela in earthquakes for the earthquake victims of Venezuela. Austin, 1801, ain't she a lot of fun? The first United States Jewish governor, David Emanuel, takes office in Georgia. And finally, on this day, in 1791, the first Internal Revenue Act. They taxed distilled spirits, better known as adult beverages, and carriages, horse and buggy, transportation. Yeah, they put a tax on it. America started getting greedy, folks. But you had to make some sort of money to survive. Ain't that beautiful? You're damn right. Hey, Dustin Wilder, Scott Link, and all my other good friends that I lived with in jolly old England. Don't you remember her, Lorelei de la Lune? Badass Age Ranger, didn't star, because danger is no stranger to an Age Ranger. Yeah, that's right. We'll always remember you, Lorelei de la Lune. Folks, let's drink and slam it home, shall we? Empty as the brain cells of an average New York Jets fan. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make the fetus a head out. So everybody take care. Have a wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything you wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill your drink. Or you might kill yourself. Or somebody else. And drinking and driving is done to being an average Yankees fan. Don't worry. If you're a fan of the Yankees there, Glenn Cunningham, I already know you're a lot smarter than the average. But what's dumber than that, though, is men slap women. Well, being a fan of Justine, I should have been swallowed because I'm such a waste of a life. Yeah, no shit, you little bitch. Beaver. But what's dumber than that, though, is men slap women. Or animal abuse. Or racism. Or people watch on Pets. Or fake friends. Or anybody that supports the fans or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church or ISIS, things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat GFY. Folks, I'll see you all on Big and A Friday. Hopefully a shorter show. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Justin Dimmitt! Hell yeah! Happy anniversary coming out of Gail Riggs' womb. And thank you for that.